Hello everyone, welcome to the Global Azure Virtual 2020. My name is Victor Rodrigues, I'm Cloud Specialist at Storm Technology in Dublin. Today I'm here to use Form Recognizer with Azure Logic Apps to analyze invoices. Today we'll see why Form Recognizer, what is Form Recognizer, and a demo. Let's start with Form Recognizer. Form Recognizer is part of the cognitive service mind solution, where you want to extract knowledge from data. There's a lot of type of forms, and any organization has forms. There's medical forms, invoices, tax, authorization forms, bank forms. And more companies have to get information of these forms and save it to a database, for example. In your company, forms come in different forms. You can have keys on the top, forms that look like with boundary box around. You can have forms with high density tables. You can have forms with multiple tables within them. So there's a ton of different kinds of forms. And what Form Recognizer is trying to do is extract the text, key value pairs, and the data from your documents. Form Recognizer have two types of model. One type is custom, where you train it and tailor it to your forms, and the other type is pre-built. The forms that we use for the demo today is the type of pre-built. One of the key benefits of the service is that it's fully managed and does not require any manual labeling. You can simply train a custom model of a small training data set. Either can be 5 filled in forms or 2 filled in forms plus 1 empty form, and you're ready to go. For the demo today, you'll be required 3 components. An Azure Blob Storage, required to store your training data. An Azure Logic Apps, required to our workflow that you get information from the storage account for training and from our mailbox for test. And a Form Recognized Service, required to execute the extraction of the information. And we can go for the demo. First, let's double check the components of the solution. Let's then understand first our invoice that will be analyzed for the Form Recognized Service. And there is our invoice. We can notice that table that has a table with the invoice number, invoice date, and so on. Now let's check the Azure resources. Here I have my resource group. The resource group contains all the resources required for this demo. I will navigate inside of the storage table to check if I have the forms required to train my form recognized service. And there it is. This is my storage table. I have a container inside, and here I have my invoice. 5 invoices required to the training data. Now let's check the form recognized service. I can open here my form recognized service. From the point of view of the service and solution, we just need 2 things, the key and the endpoint. Here I have the key and here I have the endpoint. And finally, the Azure Logic App. In the Azure Logic App, we will build the workflow to execute a proper test in the form recognized service. Let's go first to the first step. That's already done. What I did here was to make the connection from the Azure Logic Apps to my O365 account. The logic behind here is every time an email is dropped inside of the folder called my email, the logic app, you get the email look for attachment and send to the form recognized service. As you can see here, I already set here my folder, call my voices, my invoices actually, and I'm connected to my mailbox account here. The second step is configure the Logic App to use a form recognized to train the model training operation. We can start at a new step. We can search in here for form recognizer. We can pick the action train model. Here, I will call my connection form recognizer service. And I will pick my information related to my form recognized service. Here, first my API address, and here I will set my account key. And you can click create. Here, we need to set the service path. The service path is the service to the container that contains my training data set. I will copy the address here, paste here, but default here, the invoice, of course. And now clicking save, just make sure. That we have step is configured Logic App choose from recognize to analyze the invoice. I'll add here a new step, select a form recognizer, and click analyze form. Here I will pick the model ID, is the identifier of the model, and document here will be my attachments. Attachment content. Let's check here, everything's fine. And here we need another action. The action here is to get the information from the attachment or the output from the output of this action of the analyze form, and we do a compose. So we can add a new section that I add here, and we can go to data operations, and you can select compose. The inputs here will be basically my table. And that's it. We can click save. Test Logic App, I use the sample invoices in my test folder from the sample data set. From the Azure Logic App designer, I will select run. And now the workflow is active and waits to receive the email with the invoice attached. I will send the email with the sample attached to the email address. Type in my email in here. I will select the attachments. I point to my invoice test and send. And let's wait. And soon as email is delivered to the folder, the Logic App designer shows the screen with the progress of each stage. Now we will check the output of this action. And here we have the output. We can serve in here a JSON output with the sample invoice. We can simply validate if the content of the JSON is the same of the test invoice. So we have here invoice number, and the text is this number here. So we have invoice number, and here's the same number. Let's double check another information. Invoice date, for example. So we have here the invoice date and the invoice date here. Invoice date here. From here with this output, you can do many things. We can select one of the many connectors in the Azure Logic Apps to save this output to, for example, Azure Cosmos DB, Azure SQL Server, and the SharePoint list. Another possibility is, as I mentioned before, is possible to train your data set for a custom model. To do this, you need to at least 5 forms, and you can use the REST API with Python to train. And this concludes my demo. Thank you everyone for joining me today, and I hope this presentation has given you a good overview of the form recognizer service. See you soon.